I will discuss using deep learning in order to automatically annotate images. So let me start by describing what exactly is deep learning. Deep learning is the study of neural networks with many layers, much larger than what we were able to train before. And there is a lot of excitement about deep learning because it holds the promise of making computer perception as good as human perception. And this applies in all sorts of fields, so we are applying it in voice analysis, understanding what a person is saying, and identifying who is the speaker. Image analysis, understanding what's inside the image, and I will show some examples. Text analysis, this is really the new front in natural language processing. As input, we get large text. We want to extract all sorts of insights, and also in robotics and related fields. And you probably might have heard about it because it's really everywhere in the news. There's a lot of excitement around deep learning, and it's evolving very, very quickly. It's now like a sport, who's getting the better AI system faster than the other groups. Very fierce competition. All the major tech companies are investing a lot of resources in studying this field, and a lot of universities as well. Basically, all major universities are investing in this domain. The leaders are NYU, Toronto, Stanford, and Berkeley. So let me just describe AI in general, and this view is going to be very myopic, very self-centered. So a self-centered view of artificial intelligence. So as you all know, in 1996, IBM built Deep Blue, which was better in chess than the best human player at that time. So now computer chess is much better than human chess. Human chess is really no competition anymore for computer chess. So this was almost 20 years ago. What happened since? Did the promise of AI materialize itself? Do we see AI systems everywhere? Not that much, right? So 20 years since the big promise, nothing really exciting. There are a lot of advancements, but not the huge science fiction type of dreams. But this is changing, and I will show examples from our lab. So last year, last summer, we were able to present the first computer vision system that could perform face recognition better than any human. So we were able to show a computer vision, to present a computer vision system that performs better than humans. This was work done jointly with the Facebook AI research group, and here the School of Computer Science at Tel Aviv University. And this year, what I'm going to describe next, we presented a system that is able to take as input an unseen image, an image it has never seen before, and create a description of this image. So this is the dream of artificial intelligence, of computer vision. We want to get as input an image, and we want to be able to describe what we see in the image. The reason that it took so long is that AI today is not about search anymore like the chess computers. It's about learning. Just like humans are learning from samples and are getting better and better, so does machines. Machines today are able to learn from data much more effectively than before. So the task that I'm going to describe now is the task of image annotation. So the input is an unseen image. We've never seen this image before. And the output,
two girls playing soccer,
is a sentence that the computer generated after seeing this image. So this is schematically the way that this is done. We have technology that can put together in the same neural network images and text. So we start by giving the computer the image that we want to annotate, and the computer has a neural network, here you see it as boxes, it creates the first word. In this case, the word is two. Then we take the word two and we feed it to the same neural network. And the neural network thinks just a little bit and then produces the next word, which is girls. We take the word girls, we feed it, and we get the word playing, until the computer tells us that this is the end of the sentence. So we started with the image and we got the entire sentence automatically generated by the computer. So I'm going to show a few examples of sentences created by the computer for images it has never seen before. So this is a dog with ball in its mouth. And this is a basketball player in the uniform is running in the air. This is a man in black helmet is riding bike on the road. A boy is jumping into pool. And here you can see some of this, the limitations of the system. The system basically selects what to present. Here is an example that some visitors came to our lab, we let them play with the system, they selected this image, and it says two dogs are playing in the water. It actually makes a lot of sense. We trained the system on a limited number of images. It never saw any bear before. So dog is the closest it will find, so it says two dogs are playing in the water. Little ones, two cubs. Of course, the system is not perfect. It's not able to solve the problem completely. Sometimes it fails miserably, especially if different type of images than what it was trained on. So there is still a lot of work to do, and the human brain is still much better than the computer brain in this task. The specific task of annotating images is probably the most popular, hottest task in computer vision right now, and there's a lot of competition from all the major companies like Google, Baidu, Microsoft, all the major universities are playing in this. And we like the results that we get, there's a place to improve. We like that our system is a little liberal and creates new sentences and does not rely on old sentences. If we compare results on a related task of selecting the most appropriate sentence given an image out of a huge number of sentences, we can see that our system in blue has a significant advantage over all current systems just published in the last half a year by the major research labs of the world. What we are doing right now, we are expanding the system. We want to work with video. We want to be able to form complete discussions, chats around images, and these are the next steps that we are currently pursuing. In our lab, the deep learning lab at the School of Computer Science at Tel Aviv University, we study all domains related to deep learning, if it's robotics, text analysis, image analysis, and voice analysis. If you have any question regarding any of these topics, I will be very happy to just come to me after this talk and I will be very happy to discuss. Thank you very much.